inside. There is a small section outside, but at that time they didn't have the funding to make their building any larger. So they did some testing to figure out where they should actually place it. Underneath that red sediment, we've got the tan. This is that fill that washed in over time and buried our bones in layers. So it's actually a lot of different types of soil. It's all one color though because of the chemical reaction that it had with the water that was filling the sinkhole at that time. So that's what makes it all that kind of homogeneous tan color. If you look right across from that mound of dirt, we've got the lower half of a mammoth. So up at the top, we have the hips or the pelvis. We've got the upper leg bone or the femur, just like we saw at the last station. Lower leg bones. You can see the foot bone. A couple of toe bones back here. Part of the upper leg over here. And then part of the lower leg over here. So obviously we're missing the top portion of the mammoth. And it looks almost like he's half in the sinkhole and half out of it. If that's the case, it could be that the top portion didn't actually preserve like the bottom portion, so we just don't see it anymore. It could also be that a predator or a scavenger took that top portion. Or it could still be somewhere in the sinkhole. If you look just to the left of that, you'll see a skull over here. It's upside down. There are two rib bones right next to that. And there's a tusk on the pedestal right above it. So unfortunately, our bones were in that really warm water, that 90 to 95 degree water long enough that all of our collagen and DNA was leached out of them. So we don't have any DNA left at our site. And that means we can't actually tell for sure that this skull over here belongs to the same animal that's way over here. We would need that DNA to know that for sure and be able to make that assumption.